Estamos aquí, yo, con mi invitado especial desde Colombia, Bernie Varela. Ojalá que no tenga problemas de conexión o problemas técnicos, porque ustedes saben, en las últimas semanas, it's been a mess, y'all, it's been a mess. Paina. So I am going to start tonight in 1 minute because I'm actually early because I wanted to make sure that there were no technical difficulties. Okay, I'm counting down. Are you ready? I'm going to start this off with an interview I did on a TV show in Colombia, since I'm going to dedicate tonight's episode to Colombia. Dedico este episodio de mi show a Colombia.
Sí, Colombia.
Entonces, este es un video, una entrevista que hice en un programa que se llama Mañanas con Uno. A ver.
De nuestro siguiente invitado, se dice que es un nerd con el alma musical que conmueve con su voz, es políglota, escribe poemas, también canciones. Estamos hablando de Michelle es la agregada cultural de la embajada. Estamos hablando realmente de Kenny Weasley. Ahí estamos viendo imágenes de nuestro siguiente invitado. Y es que ellos los tenemos acá porque nos van a hablar, Mónica. La embajada americana está iniciando su temporada de actividades culturales en Colombia durante este 2017. Bienvenidos a Las Mañanas con Uno.
Michelle y Kenny, bienvenidos a Mañanas con Uno.
Muchas gracias.
¿Kenny habla español?
Uf, habla
ver,
Kenny
yo lo
perfecto.
Pruebo, a ver, salúdanos a ver si realmente manejas a la perfección el español.
Usted no sabe quién soy yo.
Algo acerca de tu hoja de vida, Kenny.
Pues publiqué mi primer disco en 2008, I'm Sorry, y en 2013 fui seleccionado para representar a los Estados Unidos en el concurso de canto jazz en el Festival de Jazz en Montreux, Suiza. De ahí publiqué mi segundo disco, The Real Thing, y ya, aquí estoy,
de gira,
viviendo el sueño.
Creo que un productor, un cantante ganador de Grammy dijo que tu voz es única, que no se puede comparar con ninguna otra. ¿Es verdad? ¿Quién te inspiró a ti para emprender en el mundo del jazz?
Al Jarreau, que falleció recientemente. Entre Ledisi, Rochelle Forel, Kurt Elling, muchos cantantes, pero yo diría que cada persona es única. Entonces, cada voz tiene un tono distinto.
Sí.
Pero aprecio el comentario bastante.
Claro que sí. Bueno, ¿y ustedes?
Michelle, ¿por qué arrancar con este género las actividades culturales?
Bueno, es una muy buena pregunta. Durante este mes de febrero, en los Estados Unidos celebramos el mes de historia afroamericana. En este mes destacamos todos los aportes, todas las contribuciones de los afroamericanos a la cultura estadounidense. Y tal como en Estados Unidos celebramos este mes, también la Embajada de los Estados Unidos aquí en Colombia celebra este mes con una serie de eventos para destacar, resaltar la cultura afroamericana. Y como parte de nuestra programación, hemos invitado a Kenny y su banda, The Soulful Nerd, para estar aquí con nosotros de visita. Ellos tienen una gira de dos semanas aquí en Colombia y han tenido la oportunidad de visitar hasta ahora, creo que 5 ciudades y tienen 2 más para sí. visitar. Y creemos que esa es una buena oportunidad de compartir un músico excelente con Colombia y también compartir esta cultura afroamericana. Y es un buen ejemplo de la música moderna afroamericana.
Es hoy un día.
Estén atentos porque van a estar en Manizales, Cali, Armenia, Pereira, acá en Bogotá, Bucaramanga y Medellín, en todos los centros colomboamericanos.
Ya hemos estado.
¿Ya han estado?
Todas esas ciudades
ya
hasta
pasaron.
Bogotá.
Sí.
No quedan
sí,
dos.
Tienes toda la razón. ¿Cuántos quedan solamente o cierran acá en Bogotá?
Bucaramanga y Medellín.
Tienes toda la razón. Pero además, en cada ciudad has estado haciendo talleres.
Sí.
¿Y qué has encontrado? ¿Buen potencial, buenos muchachos?
Claro, porque hemos dado talleres para músicos, estudiantes de inglés, todo tipo de gente, pero sobre todo lo que me inspiró era la pasión que tiene el pueblo colombiano en cada ciudad donde hemos estado.
Muy bien, y ahorita vamos a poder escuchar por lo menos alguno de los temas, ¿o no?
Con todo gusto.
¿Sí? Esta noche tienen una presentación, es privada.
Sí, es cierto. Esta noche vamos a celebrar con el mes de historia afroamericana en la residencia del embajador con una recepción grande para celebrar.
Ok, no tenemos tiempo para todo eso, mi gente. Yo voy a pasarle a un video de mi invitado especial, Bernie Varela, una salsa que se llama Conformate.
Óyeme, óyeme. Ajá, ajá. Con lo que le corresponde, la gente no está contenta. Con lo que le corresponde, los blancos quieren ser negros, los negros quieren ser blancos.
Confórmate con lo que tienes, confórmate.
El negro es el color de moda.
Presento a mi invitado especial desde Cali, Colombia, y Vamos a hablar un poco sobre eso durante la entrevista. Bernie Varela. Buenas tardes, buenas noches, Bernie. ¿Cómo estás?
Kenny, hermano. Bien, gracias a Dios, muy bien. Gracias por esta oportunidad de poder compartir con toda mi gente.
Para mí es todo un gusto, tú sabes. ¿Puedes presentarte a la gente explicando un poco de tu trayectoria, tu trayecto artístico y en qué estás trabajando ahora?
Claro que sí, Kenny. Bueno, yo primero que todo soy de Cali, Colombia. Cali se le conoce por su amor a la salsa. Y yo empecé mi carrera musical porque pues mi padre me influyó, mi padre es un cantante también. Y bueno, eso fue cuando tenía 14 años más o menos que empecé con música folclórica, música autóctona de nuestro país. Y tocando percusión. Y de ahí ya empecé tocando con la orquesta de mi padre, tocaba el bongó. Después me empecé a hacer coros, ya empecé a cantar y luego me transferí a otras orquestas. Y fue, por ejemplo, orquestas muy conocidas en la salsa, como es la de Nelson y sus estrellas. Después me fui con Tito Gómez, que hicimos una gira por Europa y Estados Unidos, que fue la primera vez que salí de aquí de Colombia. Eso fue en el 97. Y de ahí ya pues me quedé viviendo en Estados Unidos. Quería estudiar más. Yo tengo un bachelor en licenciatura en música. Y de ahí ya me fui para Estados Unidos, en Washington, donde conocí a mi pana Kenny Wesley en Howard University. Estudiamos juntos, hicimos la maestría y luego pues logré tener un doctorado en filosofía en estudios africanos en Howard y wow. Ser parte de la facultad.
¡Wow! ¿Puedes resumir todo esto en inglés para el resto del público? Porque I told you all I will try and, well, I told Bernie, I was going to try and do this interview in both Spanish and English because I know that I have people from all over the world that are watching. So we're going to do the majority of the interview in English, but I wanted to have some in Spanish because hay mucha gente en Colombia que está mirando ahora. Hay mucha gente en Perú que está mirando ahora. Hay mucha gente en Hispanoamérica que está mirándonos ahora. Entonces, para ustedes, quisiera hacer una parte de la entrevista en español. So, yes, could you resume that or summarize that in English for everyone?
Sure, Kenny, especially because you have a lot of fans. I have been in your concerts. You had a lot of fans. And yes, I'm from Cali, Colombia. I grew up in a neighborhood that is very popular about salsa. We are crazy about salsa. I studied music here at the university in Cali, Universidad del Valle. Then I started playing with my daddy's band. Actually, the first instrument that I played were the traditional instruments that we play in the folk music. And then when I graduated and then I moved to the United States and then I went to Harvard University. He met Kenny and we started together. Later, I did my PhD, actually last year, graduating, my PhD in African Studies. And I have been, playing with different well-known salsa bands, las Tito Gómez, Tito Gómez, yeah. He passed away a couple of years ago. That was when I played with him here in Cali, it took me for a tour in United States and Europe. That was, you know, an amazing experience, my first time that I went out of the country. Basically that's, you know, everything that I do, because my dad is an amazing singer, you know, an amazing musician. I think that I got that from him.
What's your father's name? ¿Cómo se llama tu papá?
Hernando Varela.
Hernando Varela. So, isn't there also another very famous Varela from Cali as well?
No, actually, you're referring to Jairo Varela. Yeah, but Jairo Varela is from Chocó. He's another state from here in Colombia. And he's, you know, he's so famous. He was the creator of Grupo Niche, one of the most representative salsa band that Colombia had. Yeah.
So when I was in Cali a few years ago, we passed this plaza where there was a statue made in his image. And I was wondering, was that your relative?
Yeah, you know, everybody think about that, because for the last name, of course, I knew him, and I know, you know, his sister, you know, his family, they are very, very, very nice, very kind, nice family, and he was an amazing musician, great composer. I look at him.
Excellent. So explain to the audience who Grupo Niche is and was, and what their... what mark they left on Latin music.
Yes, that's one of the biggest names, not only here in Colombia, in the salsa world, you know, Grupo Niche. That Niche means black, you know, it's like a cute way to say, you know, you are black. Let's say, Niche, how are you? Hey, Niche, ¿cómo estás? You know, and they, you know, he was a great composer, and the first time, well, for the first one was Fruco, the first band, you know, Colombian band was Fruco, that got that recognition, you know, and the second one was Grupo Niche, you know, he got that recognition as a huge salsa giant, and I think he was an amazing composer, that he did a lot for the diaspora, because in his composition, he mentioned, you know, that part, the African diaspora, and that, I think that was the most relevant job that he did to include, you know, our family in that legacy.
What? So prior to Grupo Niche, was there any mention of the African connection to that style of music?
There were another bands, but I think that people were not aware of that link that we have with Africa. And I think that Jairo Varela underlined that, you know. He said, okay, wait a second, you know, let me highlight, you know, that African descent part that we had.
Okay, so for the public who does not know, why is there an African connection to, let's say, salsa music or let's say, Colombian culture in general? Why is there that connection there? Because I'm talking everyone to a doctor. He has a doctor in African studies from Howard University, and his research area, I'll let him go into that, but it deals with culture and Afro identity in the Colombian culture.
Yeah, exactly. We had a huge African influence, you know, according to the history. mostly like I can say that 30% of the of Colombia's population is African descent.
Wow.
Colombia is the second that has a large African descent population after Brazil. Wow. In Latin America. Yeah. So it's, and you can see the influence in the music that we have, also in the salsa, the rhythms, you know, instruments. Speaking of that, my experience that I was in Senegal at the beginning of the year, and I saw that how, you know, people follow salsa, they love it. That was amazing. I was like, and they know, you know, the songs that I know, because I went to play, you know, with a band. I don't speak French like you. I don't speak Wolof, and they don't speak English. You know, some people don't speak English. I say, when I speak with the musician, hey, do you know this song, El Cuarto de Tula? Or do you know Guantanamera? Oh, yeah. They know all the standards, salsa standards. They know. That's amazing. Yeah. That's amazing.
That's kind of like when I go to a random country in the middle of nowhere and there's like a jazz band and they know all of these American standards. What did it make you feel like knowing that these musicians on the other side of the world knew your music that you grew up on?
Yeah, that was amazing, because actually the a welcome party there that we had, it was a small band, a 5-piece band, and they played one song that is called I Boy, and that song was a hit here in Colombia. And when they start playing that, I said, I know that song, I can do that, and I do in my, you know, my wall of the Wolof version.
So the song was recorded in Wolof.
Yes, that was recorded in Wolof.
Explain to the audience what Wolof is.
Yeah, Wolof is an African language that is spoken in Senegal. And that song was recorded by a band that was in New York that is called Africando. Africano, and they record us in a salsa, and that was a hit here in Colombia. And I think all the people who love salsa recognize that song.
Incredible. So did you learn the Wolof words while you were there?
When I was there, I said, okay, what this means? And they explained me, you know, this song is that talks about the moon, that says to your boy, but that's it. I was singing, you know, but I didn't know what I was saying, you know. It was funny.
So I have one more question for you before we have our mini salsa concert.
Great.
Bernie ha preparado un par de canciones para nosotros para calmarnos durante estos tiempos locos. Okay, estamos viviendo en tiempos de locura. So, yeah. My question is, what are the origins of salsa? Some people say it started in Cuba. Some people say it started in Puerto Rico. Some people say it started in New York City. Where did salsa begin?
Well, as you said, there are different theories, you know.
Salsa?
Yes, but that's the main. But I think that it comes from Africa, brother. And now that I was there in Senegal, oh, brother, yes, that comes from Africa. The name, you know, got his popularity in New York, you know, with the mix of Puerto Ricans, the people from Dominican Republic, or Latinos who were living in New York, you know. But it's definitely those readings, you know, are from Africa.
Wow. So when did they start adding the trumpets and all of the other, the various instruments to it. What I guess my, the heart of my question is, what aspects of salsa are African?
Well, I think the rhythms.
Okay.
The rhythms, yeah, definitely. Some the rhythms and that the question and answer, you know. Mm-hmm. His salsa has call, you know, that part, what we call call and response, is yeah. What I'd say. And in salsa we got what is coro y soneo, you know. But definitely the rhythms, yeah, I think so, yeah.
You know, there, I was in Bolivia a few years ago, and we learned about an Afro-Bolivian style of music called saya. And in a lot of the songs, well, of course, the drums are the foundation of the style. It's a rhythm. But yeah. There was a lot of call and response in it. And it was just so emotional for me to see all of these different reincarnations of African traditions all over the world. So we have the rhythm. Are there particular drums that are used with salsa that we can kind of connect to the African continent?
Yeah, I think the one that is called La Conga, you know, is a very, very important in salsa, you know, the heart of the salsa. The heart of the rhythm of salsa. I think the conga is like a, actually, let me see if I have something. Well, actually, I have something that I can show you. this is not like, this is an instrument from the Pacific Coast of Colombia. This I have here in my room. This is called cununo. This is cununo. This is a wood, you know, wood. And this is the skin. And a conga looks like, no, looks like this.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a cununo.
Cununo?
Cununo, yeah, that's the name. That is.
Excellent. So, thank you for our history lesson. Now we're ready to hear you sing.
Ay, ay, ay. Okay. Do you want to sing with me? I had to tell you guys, Kenny Wesley, I invite Kenny to sing with me in my latest album. And with the beautiful song that is called Te Voy a Amar.
Written by this one of our good friends, Hugo Tobar.
Yeah. Hugo Tobar was the composer. And also the arranger was Marino Luis. These two brothers are from Buenaventura. Buenaventura is a small port here. One of the most important ports in Colombia. So actually where the salsa came from to Colombia was through that port. When I was here. Yeah.
Wow. I would love to sing it, but I have a question about Buenaventura. So when you said salsa came through there, do you mean that was like the major port of entry for like new products, goods, and things from other countries?
Yeah, according to the history, the ships that were coming, the sailors, they brought, you know, LPs, you know. yes. And that was, you know, the salsa start from Buenaventura.
I hate to keep asking questions, but I just have, you're just so wise, you know so much, I gotta keep asking. So I heard it said while I was in Cali that Cali is the international capital of salsa.
Yes.
Explain that. How does that happen? Were they given that award? Is it like a UN a UNESCO recognized term, title.
No. This is mostly like a, I guess people who come here to visit. And first of all, for the love that people have, you know, Colombians have for salsa, especially people who hear from Cali. When I was younger, you know, I can hear my neighborhood playing, you know, with his speaker, you know, high volume playing salsa, my other in front of my house playing, and many, many Puerto Ricans, Cubans, come, you know, here to perform, to concerts, and they are very, very welcome. And sometimes the Colombian musicians get jealous. Oh, come on, man. We can do this too, but it's the way, you know, it's kind of another deal. But yes. People, especially also the dancers. I don't know if you saw the Super Bowl that was
J-Lo and Shakira.
Yes, with the guys who were dancing there, the salsa. They were from here, from Cali, Colombia.
Hey! And you know, I met a young man while I was in Cali he's won many, many awards dancing salsa. He's an excellent dancer and musician. He was studying at your university there. ¿Cómo se llama la universidad? Universidad del Valle.
Universidad del Valle. Uh-huh. Yes. Uh-huh.
He was studying there and an excellent salsa dancer. So what song are you going to do first? Let's do ours last. They didn't come to see me. They came to see you.
Okay, let me look for... I'm going to do... let me change my place here. I'm going to do this song that's called Vive el Momento. You know?
Me encanta.
This is a song that I was inspired when I read the book by... Eckhart Tolle, The Power of Now.
Mm-hmm.
What's an important message? You know, then you don't need to worry about the future or what happened, because that already happened. You can do anything about it. So sorry, I was looking for the track. Yes. But I have to tell you something. In this track, I had a, you know, very, very amazing musicians. I have Ruben Rodriguez on bass.
Oh, wow.
I have Luisito Quintero, you know, those are the Mark Anthony's favorite musician. Oh, my God, what is it? Axel Tosca on piano. And I did this. I invite Michael Chacon in this song, but he's not here in this. You see what is he? Ay, ay, ay. Sorry, Kenny. I got it. Bueno, eso se llama.
Explícale a la gente dónde está.
Se llama...
¿Estás en Washington D.C. ahora?
No, estoy en Cali, Colombia.
Explícanos por qué. Why are you in Cali, Colombia right now?
Well, I came for this spring break, you know. Spring break is like 5 days, just 1 week. But in that moment, the coronavirus was getting... Sorry, I had a hair. In that moment, coronavirus was getting crazy here in Colombia, and the president, Colombian president, decided to close the airports. So here, I'm still here. They're not gonna open the airport yet.
At least you're with family and
I'm trapped safe. In Colombia.
not a horrible place to be trapped.
exactly. Okay.
Okay. Pues, yeah. Damas y caballeros, les presento Bernie Varela.
Hey, vamos. Okay, play more volume.
vivo el presente, no el pasado. Y tranquilo que el futuro va a llegar.
Esta música es para bailar, pero no se puede. Salgo de la cámara.
Listo. Voy a intentar. Voy a intentar desde aquí.
Vive tú el presente y no el pasado. Y tranquilo que el futuro no ha llegado. Oye, lo que pasó, pasó, pasó. No te robes el tiempo. Si te sigues lamentando, te perderás el momento. Vive el presente y no el pasado. Y tranquilo que el futuro no ha llegado. Y yo no sé si llegará. Y yo no sé si pasará. Lo que importa es el ahora. Oye, vamos a gozar el ahora.
Vive el presente y no el pasado. Tranquilo que el futuro no ha llegado.
Oye, y esto es para que lo gocen allá en Europa, Michael Chacón, que está tu parte, ¿ok? En España. Y viene el coro. Ay, aquí en Wesley, goza, goza, goza.
Oye, gózatela, disfruta la vida, oye, goza, gózatela,
vacila, gózatela,
¿qué es lo que hago? ¿Qué es lo que hice? Oye, vamos a bailarlo,
vacila, gózatela,
que te quede bien claro que la hora es el que es.
Que te quede bien claro que ahorita es lo que importa, ¿ok? Yo sé, estamos pasando por un momento difícil, pero esto pasa, va a pasar. Entonces, viene esta parte que dice. Que te quede claro, que te quede claro.
El presente
hay que vivirlo.
El pasado
consumado,
el futuro,
y quién lo sabe,
el presente,
vive, vive el momento,
el pasado,
ya no vuelve más,
el futuro,
oye, el futuro nadie lo sabe, solo el de allá arriba, ¿ok? Así que, o sea,
vive tú el presente, no el pasado. Y tranquilo que el futuro no ha llegado.
Ambo. Esta es la parte que más me gusta. Ponle cuidado.
Vacílate, gózatela, disfruta el momento.
Vacílate,
oye,
relájate,
vamos a gozar.
Vacílate,
vamos a vacilar.
Relájate,
oye, relaja. Que el pasado no importa.
Oye, solo el futuro, gay. ¿Okay? Ahí viene la parte de Luisito Quintero.
¡Ataca, Quintero!
¡Hey! ¡Ja, ja! Pana.
Sí, pana.
Esa fue Vive el Momento.
Perfecto. ¿Y qué tienes ahora?
Vamos a ver qué tengo aquí.
¿Cuál es el sencillo del disco actual?
Esta canción viene en el disco actual, sí, señor.
Pero tengo aquí. ¿Fue el primer sencillo que salió?
Ajá, exacto, exacto.
Ok.
Exacto. Tengo una canción que la primera que compuse cuando llegué a Estados Unidos, porque extrañaba mucho, ¿no? Extrañaba todo. y esta canción se llama Nostalgia y en ritmo de cha cha cha, ¿ok?
Hey, cha cha cha
cha cha cha. Póngale cuidado.
Cha 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 es de Cuba, ¿no?
Sí.
Nostalgia. Nostalgia.
Sí, nostalgia, homesick. Ah, ya, dice.
Homesick.
Cha cha cha. Estoy con los pelos, oye, el viento me llenó. Cha cha cha. Le pasa el giro. Oliver.
¿Cómo te extraño, tierra mía? Qué vacío que siento hoy. Por más dinero que aquí encuentre, no me acostumbro a esta frialdad. Extraño el calor de mi gente, sus creencias, su creatividad. La cantaleta de mis padres, la fiesta de mi vecindad.
Oye, el alboroto de mi barrio, lo extraño, lo extraño. No, mentira, ya no. Aquí venía el Manny, tiene que estar rapeando. Ahí.
¿Cómo te añoro, tierra mía? Qué vacío que siento hoy. Por más sueños que he logrado, algo me falta en mi interior. Extraño amigos, familiares, el tiempo libre, el no hacer nada. Esos ríos, sus paisajes, esa música nacional.
Oye, mi currulao, mi cumbia, mi champeta, mi vallenato. María. Ahí viene. Viene la flauta, pero es la flauta traversa, ¿eh? Nostalgia, quiero decirte que ahí participan también muchos amigos míos, Juanito Murillo, que toca con el grupo Nietzsche, y su hermano, que es de la tropa, que hicimos muchas de sus cosas en el estudio, y un panita que falleció, Leo Sarria, en los coros. Esa es la canción Nostalgia.
I was, I, I,
Gracias, gracias.
So everybody watching, Bernie cannot see me.
So I'm no, here. No puedo verte la cara. No, imposible.
I'm cutting a fool over here. You can't see any of it. This is really funny. I'm out of breath because I'm dancing all hard over here.
It is. I cannot see you. I don't know what are you doing. I don't know. Oh, my God. But this is part of the experience, you know?
You're going to crack up laughing when you watch this back.
Oh, my God. I
so.
I can't wait to see this video.
¿Qué nos toca ahora?
Bueno, it's your turn. Tu turno, Kenny. Vamos a hacer la canción que se llama Te Voy a Amar.
¿Qué la significa canción? Te voy a amar. What does te voy a amar mean?
I'm gonna love you.
I'm gonna love you. Okay.
Fue muy fuerte. Ay. Un momentico que estoy buscando la canción. Yes. You know, actually, oh my God, where is it?
So everyone, side story. I wish I had the footage. I should have pulled it up for the show today. When we were working on this in the studio, Bernie was very tough on me. I was horrible. I am not used to singing to a clave. I'm used to singing 4-4, 3-4, 5-4, something where there's like a very clearly defined one every time. And I'm used to like falling into that and my ad-libs and my embellishments are all based on that feeling that I have in my body, and I couldn't get the feeling of the clave. And I'm sure they chopped, cut, twisted, edited the heck out of my vocal.
No. You did a great job.
It was very
and actually
talented.
we were talking about, you know, how this, you know, how each genre has, you know, these different styles. I was talking to you about the R&B that you say, no, it's opposite to the salsa. It's a little behind. We sing. Yes. That's amazing. And I can do that. I cannot sing like you. Oh, my God.
But I can't sing like you.
No, you did. You did it here.
Mentira.
Sí, tú lo hiciste. Muy bien.
Gracias. Muy bien. Pues es buen profesor.
Existe y me encanta porque cuando I love when because when Kenny sings, he has like oh my God, it's like a lot of love, a lot of feeling, mucho sentimiento. Yo quiero cantar como tú mucho sentimiento. Y cuando él hizo esta parte que le toca hacer, muy bien, yeah, mucho sentimiento. ¿Estamos listos?
Sí.
Bueno, vamos a soltarla. Vamos a ver, espérate. Ahora. Vaya. Marino Luis, ¿cómo tomar? Buenaventura, todo lo tuyo.
Y desde esa noche me di a tu sonrisa. Con tu tierna mirada, yo me di a tus labios, yo me di a tu vida. Y desde esa noche nos unió el destino. Ya no existen rutas ni trayectos cortos, solo hay un camino. Te voy a amar, te lo aseguro. Ya no existen dudas que ya yo soy tuyo. Te voy a amar, te lo aseguro. Ya nuestras vidas son solo futuro. ¡Kenny!
vuelvo a ti. No tengo miedo, muero por ir. Estoy en mi propio cielo.
Estamos en el estudio, es más, aquí tengo mi chancuco, leyendo, viendo la letra porque no me recordaba de esa canción. Muy linda canción. Sí. Beautiful song.
Millón de gracias por invitarme a colaborar contigo en esa canción.
Oh, gracias.
Un honor.
Gracias a ti.
Pues.
Gracias a ti.
Algunas preguntitas más.
Ok. Pregunta, que tenemos tiempo, ¿no? Mira, Kenny, there is nothing else to do. No hay nada que hacer.
Siempre hay algo más para hacer. Por ejemplo, especially, tú estás trabajando en algo, ¿no? En algunos
proyectos. Mira, Kenny, fíjate que ahorita estoy trabajando en un proyecto más académico. Quiero escribir un libro acerca de mi trabajo de doctorado.
Wow. Yay. So what was the topic of your doctoral thesis? So he said that he's working on a book right now based on his doctoral thesis.
Yeah, I did research in one musical expression that is from the Pacific coast of Colombia that is called curulao. It's an African descent, you know. It has a lot of African descent influence, sorry. And basically, my research was how this music became as a form of resistance.
A form of resistance from the political structure, or?
Yeah, for, you know, oh my God, for all the struggle that the people from the region, you know, have to face, have to deal with, you know, it's a lot of material for a writer book, let me tell you.
So what are some of those, struggles that people deal with in that region, Colombia?
Well, violence, you know, unfortunately, there is a huge problem between guerrillas and government paramilitary groups. It's a mess. It's a mess. And unfortunately, the people, you know, the habitants are the people who suffer all of this crazy war.
So how did the curulao begin being used in that region of Colombia? And when did it start to kind of be used as a form of resistance?
This is from colonization, you know. One of the things that I did in my research was to analyze the lyrics of the song. And the lyrics, you know, they discuss, you know, they discuss all of these issues, like besides violence, you know, lack of water, lack of potable water, lack of infrastructure. Corporations in complicity with the government, you know, steal the resources, politicians. This is crazy. And they have been using this form, you know, this cultural expression to protest against all of those issues.
What do you think, other than, well, I'll ask two questions based on this. How much of an impact do you think this music has had on the culture in Colombia in terms of getting people aware of the issues that are going on in that region?
Yeah, that's a great question, Kenny, because this music, you know, it's amazing how this music cannot compete, but let me explain this in a different way. You know, radio stations, you know, TV, you know, the media, they support, you know, all readings, you know, that they pay, you know, they do millionaire campaigns, you know, and to listen to reggaeton. But this music, you know, the artists don't have the resources to pay a radio station to play this music. However, this music had been for years. And the good thing about it is that young people prefer this music instead of that music that they listen in the radios all, you know, every day. Wow. And I have been in the communities, you know, when playing music, you know, with a band, I play salsa, I play, you know, cumbia, but when we play a curulao, people go crazy. And that's amazing, you know, how people don't change, you know, this music. And also this recognition, you know, has been so huge that there is an amazing festival that is happening here in Colombia that became, you know, one of the most important festivals in Colombia is called Petronio Álvarez. Unfortunately, because, you know, this COVID-19, the festival is not going to happen this year. But this festival is huge, huge. And many scholars from different countries come to see the festival, you know, to see what's going on. Why this is, you know, so amazing.
So at the festival, there's lots of different performances of various styles of folkloric music?
Yes, specifically from the Pacific Coast.
Okay.
And one of the things is that the performers are coming from places that are, you know, difficult to access, you know. For instance, mm-hmm. if I'm going to visit a place, you know, I had to take to drive, you know, like a three hours from Cali to Buenaventura, and then from Buenaventura I had to take a boat. Oh my God, a boat for 12 hours, you know. We had to navigate the Pacific, and then there are other, when you arrive to the, let's see, El Charco or Huapi, or when you arrive to those places, you want to go get farther, you need to take another small boat and get more, you know. And so this, and the good thing about this festival is that people who live in those regions, you can see them in that festival, you know.
Yes.
And you don't have to do all that journey, you know, traveling, all that crazy. Because those 12 hours in that boat, oh my God, King, let me tell you, he's like that. Woo!
If you go to one of those towns that are in those very remote areas, are they speaking Spanish only, or are they speaking mixtures of dialects and languages, and what is the culture like in these remote regions?
They speak Spanish mostly.
Okay.
But for instance, in the other coast, in the Atlantic, they in Palenque de San Basilio, they speak Palenquero.
Mm-hmm.
That is an African language that they create, you know, a mix of Bantu language with Spanish and Creole.
Yes. Wow. So Palenquero, for everybody out there, think of it as kind of like a French Creole language, where you have lots of different languages coming together, forming it. But the structure of the language is African. The grammatical structure and the syntactical structure of the language is African.
Yeah, one of our colleagues, you know, Dr. Watton, she did an excursion to Palenque, San Basilio de Palenque, and I was with her. That was amazing. We took Howard students to San Basilio de Palenque.
You have so many stories, man. I can have you up here all night.
Awesome.
Well, great. So where can people find your music? ¿En dónde se puede encontrar tu música, tu calendario de conciertos, y tu gira?
Kenny, let me tell you that the concerts are, oh my God, with this virus, virtual concerts only.
Pero eso da... Podemos incluir conciertos virtuales en tu calendario, ¿no?
Exactly. For instance, the situation that is happening here in Colombia is crazy, you know, in about the restrictions, you know. For instance, according to my ID, I can go out only one day during the week, you know, to buy food.
One day a week?
Yes.
Well, you know, and that's not horrible if you buy enough, because I have enough now where I'm probably good for 2-3 weeks.
Okay. Yeah. But you know, it's kind of it's crazy. There is sometimes during the weekend there is it's called ley seca, like that people cannot buy any liquor at all.
Oh wow. Do you need like a special pass or sheet of paper to be able to go out? I know in France they're doing that. To go to the grocery store, you need like a specific piece of paper.
No, no, no. I mean, they ask you for your ID. See, for instance, my ID ends in 2, so I can go out Mondays.
Very clever. Yeah. Okay.
When I go to the store, the grocery store, the first guy, hey, let me see your ID. If I'm okay, they let me in. If I'm not, I can't.
Wow. Are there any foreigners who are trapped in Colombia right now?
I haven't heard that, but I mean, I think so because they decide, you know, to close the airport. Gosh. So, and they don't know when they're gonna open.
I actually would probably be very happy to be there right now.
Well, fortunately that we can teach, you know, virtually, you know.
I after my trip to Colombia, I have been telling everybody about Calentao. I love that dish. Oh, so many great dishes.
Let me ask you something. When you were here in Colombia, what do you like the most?
I always like the people the most wherever I go. Some places have, you know, food that I like a lot, but I always find something I enjoy food-wise in every country because I like to eat. But I always have carried a memory of the people with me. As you know, as performers, when we're there, people are always appreciative of art and they have very high level of respect for artists. And it's such a rewarding feeling to know that what you're doing is being received with gratitude and with love. So that's probably my greatest memory, the people.
Great. Great.
Yeah. And I would say out of everywhere we went, I can't pick one region. I stay in touch with many, many people who I met while we were there from all regions, from Buenaventura, from Cali, from Pereira, from all over. yeah, the people. That's my greatest memory. What's your greatest memory or the thing you like the most about the United States? And the thing you like most about Colombia? Other than Chontaduro.
Chontaduro. Oh, my God. I love it. I love Chontaduro. But we cannot go outside. There are no Chontaduros at all. I haven't seen anything. Really bad.
Oh, pobrecito.
Yeah.
I don't like that fruit, everybody. I'm sorry. I loved my time in Colombia, but I did not enjoy my experience with Chontaduro.
Danny, come on, man.
I'll try it again, though. You have to show me the good Chontaduro, and I'll try it again.
Yes, please. Well, going back to your question, what I like most is also the people here in Colombia, you know, is very warm. Even that things has changed, you know, for instance, in my neighborhood, we got different neighbors. It's not the same that it was before, but still, people are very kind. Mm-hmm. Yeah. For United States, oh my God, for United States, what can I say?
McDonald's.
Oh, no, are you crazy? No. Well, also there are nice people. They're nice people, yeah. I am blessed that I surround, but I'm nice people? Yeah. And of course, you know what things? I love the museums in Washington.
Yeah.
Because I can. Oh my God, I can spend the whole day in those, the culture, you know, those positions. There was one in the, what was it, National Geographic? about the Egypt. Mm. Oh, that was amazing. Yeah, I love that. The museum. Yes.
Pues, algunas palabras que quieres compartir con el público colombiano y el público hispano hablante que está mirándonos esta noche.
Bueno, pues muchísimas gracias por esta oportunidad de compartir con tu público, tu audiencia que te quiere mucho. Yo he estado en los conciertos de Kenny. Yo soy un fan de Kenny. ¿Crees que me encanta como Kenny? Me encanta como Kenny canta.
Gracias.
Y tienes que... Y me gusta que eres generoso. Me refiero que te gusta compartir el escenario con otros artistas, otros cantantes. Y eso lo vi mucho cuando fui a ver Stevie Wonder. Stevie Wonder es una persona que hace lo mismo. Le gusta que participen diferentes personas. Y tú tienes esa generosidad. Eso me parece interesante. Those who have not seen Kenny Wesley live, well, you had to see him. Kenny invited me to play with him at the Blues Alley. Oh, that was amazing performance. Kenny, Blues Alley, I had a great time. I look at him, Kenny, you know, for his, because he's an amazing human being. You know, he's a humble, sencillo, tranquilo, and an amazing musician. So I hope everything is gonna get better. I know about this crisis. Think positively, and enjoy your quarantine. Soon.
I am so happy we were able to make this happen, and that the delay wasn't too bad. But thank you so much, Vernie. I just think the world of you. You know that. I am one of your biggest fans, and I wish you so much success. So the name of your most recent album is what? ¿Cómo se llama tu disco actual?
Sí, este es un álbum que hice con mi amigo Jorge Murillo, mi compadre. La rumba no se acaba. La tropa y la rumba no se acaba.
No se acaba.
La rumba doesn't end. Yes.
And where can they find your music? ¿Dónde se puede encontrar tu música? Yo tengo tu música aquí abajo, pero da igual. Dino todas las redes sociales.
Yeah, all the digital platforms, iTunes, Apple Music, CD Baby. All of those digital platforms.
Instagram, Facebook, Twitter.
Yes, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Bernie Varela Music. Bernie con la B de vaca, ¿ok? Con la B de... No, la B de Victoria, porque tengo las dos B. Bernie Varela.
Un abrazo internacional.
Ana, cuídate mucho. Cuídate mucho, parce.
Muchísimas gracias, pana. Vamos a cerrar esta vaina con un video de una versión de la canción clásica de Michael Jackson, You Are Not Alone, pero una versión romántica, una salsa romántica por Bernie Varela. Muchísimas gracias por venir, pana.
Dios Ana, thank you. I am.
Otro día más y tú ya no estás. ¿Cómo puede ser que no estés aquí? Ya dijiste adiós, que no sé por qué. Viste que partí, dejar mi mundo así. Me siento y yo me pregunto
Y'all, this is another song from his recent album, Me Rompiste el Corazón, one of his recent albums. It's the album right before this latest one, Me Rompiste el Corazón.
Mi propio yo, te confié y te brindé mi vida entera en su esplendor. Mi juventud ya se agotó, total resulta que me rompiste el corazón, te burlaste sin dolor, pero me hice más fuerte. Entregué mi
mi corazón. Te burlaste del amor y eso cambió mi suerte. Me rompiste el corazón, te burlaste sin dolor, pero me hice más fuerte. Lastimaste mi ilusión, te burlaste de mi amor, pero me hice más fuerte. Yo te confié y te brindé mi vida entera en su esplendor. Mi juventud ya se agotó. Total, resulta que me rompiste el corazón. Te burlaste sin dolor, pero me hice más fuerte. Lastimaste mi ilusión, te burlaste del amor, pero me hice más fuerte. Me rompiste el corazón. Te burlaste sin dolor, pero me hice más fuerte. Lastimaste mi ilusión, te burlaste del amor, pero me hice más fuerte.
Que les vaya muy bien, bendiciones a todos y a todas. Hasta la próxima, un abrazo.